Smart Speaker Projector Thermal Feasibility Study. In the first couple of minutes, I will summarize the major points, present objectives and conclusions, and after that, we will elaborate more on details as we go through the rest of the presentation. Our objective was to determine if thermal solution with natural convection exists for a 120 lumen LED base projector that can fit on top of a smart speaker. In other words, the question was, if we had a small space available, could we fit a projector inside that space that would be 120 lumen LED base projector and also be cooled by a natural convection only, which means no fan, no moving parts that would make noise. We will discuss this in part one of the presentation. DMD chosen for this project is 0.23 QHD DMD, and LEDs are 1 mm squared Osram LEDs, which are Osram's latest iteration, high efficiency LEDs. Optics used would have F number of 1.7. This would be a second iteration that we considered, and in this case, we wanted to make a design that would be of low cost, which means a heat sink that could be a simple extruded piece of aluminum that is sliced into pieces with no heat pipes that would add to the cost. Also, a simulation run with a slowly moving silent fan is added into the mix so that we can assess effect of adding a little bit of forced air movement. The conclusion is that, yes, it is possible to make a 120 lumen LED base projector that can fit on top of a smart speaker that is cooled only by natural convection. All the temperatures checked out, and yes, we think it is possible. In part two, we will try to answer the immediate question that comes after every simulation, which is, can we trust this simulation and how it compares to measurement? We built a heatsink prototype, mounted an electrical heater on it, put thermocouples on it, we got the measurements, and we compared thermal resistances of simulated heatsink with measured values. The results show that thermal resistance obtained by simulation is 6 to 10% higher than measured values, which translates into simulation temperatures being 2 to 3.5 degrees Celsius higher than measured values. I would say a decent accuracy for a simulation. Also, error is in conservative direction, meaning in reality we have more margin than what a simulation predicted. Part 1. 120 lumen LED base projector with natural convection. This slide shows geometry used in simulation. The optical engine and heat sinks fit into the cylindrical cavity, which is defined by the cover, and the entire setup is immersed in air. Cover has openings at the bottom and at the top, and its purpose in the model is to restrict the airflow and make flow conditions more realistic. Optical engine protrudes to the side, and projection lens would be added to it, probably pointing downwards, and would project the image on the surface in front of the smart speaker. There are four separate heat sinks in this design, three for LEDs, red, green, and blue, and one for the DMD. Picture on the left side shows how the LEDs are mounted, each on its own interface plate, and placed directly against heat sink walls. DMD is thermally connected to the DMD heat sink through aluminum heat stud. Heat sinks have fins that are 1.6 mm thick due to requirements set by extrusion process. The pitch of 5.6 mm bodes well with natural convection. That's what we generally need in a heat sink that should work with natural convection, a larger pitch. DMD also needs to be cooled, and this DMD heat sink is interesting one, because normally we have a fan that moves the air around, and a typical heat sink that we see on our DMDs is much smaller. Also, note that red LED heatsink is the largest, and we will explain reason for that a couple of slides later. Here we present the results for natural convection flow, and we show the flow field and temperature field. The solution is for 120 lumen LED based projector. On the left side, one can identify that the maximum temperature value is 88.5 degrees Celsius for green LED and maximum air velocity is 0.28 meters per second. It is a slow airflow, and as you can see, the velocity vectors show that air enters at the bottom of the cavity, by buoyancy is driven upwards and exits through the slots at the top, as it was expected. On the right side, more numerical details are given. Total heat load is 6 watts at assumed ambient temperature of 40 degrees Celsius. Most notably, all LED junction temperatures are well below the limits allowed by manufacturer's data sheets, and active array temperature also is maintained below maximum allowed value of 70 degrees Celsius. LED's luminous flux as a function of temperature is provided by LED manufacturers' data sheets. Although maximum junction temperatures allowed are 120 degrees Celsius for red LED and 150 degrees Celsius for green and blue LEDs, typically we do not want our junction temperatures to go that high. Note how efficiency of red LED drops with temperature. Running red LED close to the maximum allowed temperature would not only reduce the optical power, it would spoil the color point as well. These results, where junction temperatures are 77, 88, and 72 degrees Celsius, guarantee that desired brightness and color point would be achieved. One of the objectives for this project was to add a slowly moving fan to assess the effect of forced convection compared to natural convection flow. For this purpose, we picked one off-the-shelf slowly moving silent fan, less than 17 decibels at nominal speed, and then assumed that fan would run at 30% of its nominal speed. Fan curve on the right describes how the static pressure depends on volumetric flow rate through the fan. Blue fan curve represents nominal speed, and yellow curve, which was used in simulation, is for 30% of nominal fan speed and would guarantee an extremely low noise level. When a slowly moving fan was added on top of the heat sink, it had a dramatic impact, of course, and maximum temperatures dropped by roughly 30 degrees Celsius, while maximum air velocity went up 5 times to 1.5 meters per second. That gives us an option with plenty of margin that can be used either to reduce the size of the heatsink if it proves impractical to use large heatsinks, or to increase the brightness if 120 lumen ends up not being bright enough. Adding a quiet, slowly moving fan that could be positioned strategically so that noise does not affect performance on the smart speaker would tremendously improve the thermal solution. Part 2. Heatsink thermal resistance, simulation versus measurement. In order to verify simulation results, a heat sink prototype was built. An electrical heater was attached to it along with 4 thermocouples on several locations on heat sink and a set of measurements was taken. Heat sink resistance was calculated according to the formula, and measurements were then compared to simulation results. Picture on the right shows the measurement setup: heat sink, an electrical heater under the cover, power source, and data logger. Note that heat sink was covered to obstruct the airflow, as it would be in actual smart speaker application. By varying the source power, we were able to measure the heat sink thermal resistance for several input values ranging from 3 to 7 watts. Thermal resistance is calculated as maximum temperature difference divided by the heat load. Results obtained by the simulation were 6 to 10% higher than the measured values, which we consider to be a good match. Simulation shows 2 to 3.5 degrees Celsius higher temperatures when compared to measurement. Simulation error is in conservative direction, which is a good thing and makes our margin for that much larger. In summary, we can say that simulation showed that 120 lumen LED-based projector is thermally feasible by using natural convection in a smart speaker-sized format. Also, we verified simulation results by comparing them to measurements.